and welcome back to Proactive New York. With me right now is Ben Wolff, CEO at Sarcos Robotics. Ben, it's great to meet you. How are you today?
Doing great, Christine. Thanks for having me today.
Of course, it's great to see you. Lots to talk about today, including an exciting SPAC merger. Before we get to that, tell us a bit more about Sarcos.
Sarcos is an industrial robotics company focused on bringing robotics to market that augment humans instead of replace them. So instead of being about automation, we're about enabling human workers to do more and to do it safely.
Yeah, these are some really cool kind of robot suits. So how do they work?
So we have built a fully electric wearable robot that the human can get inside of it and start lifting up to 200 pounds with no stress or strain on the human body. So it is something straight out of the pages of science fiction. We've read about it or seen it in the movies for, you know, years and years, and it's finally reality today.
So tell me a bit about your aim to use robot as a service. What does that mean?
What we do is we provide our machines to our customers. We provide all of the maintenance and service and support, and it goes on our customers' payroll, just like a human worker would. So it is a partner for existing workers. We're paid monthly. We service and maintain it, ensure uptime, and the customer doesn't have to write a big CapEx check up front. It's just part of their payroll.
So you're really like a Tony Stark here of Iron Man. So what can you now tell me about the group's intention to merge with SPAC called Rotor Acquisition?
So our focus is on getting the merger completed sometime in the third quarter. That will bring us a significant amount of capital, and it will also allow public investors to invest in us along the way, which they haven't been able to do so far as we've been a private company.
And when would you expect this to close?
Hoping to close it in the third quarter.
And from my understanding, you will be raising around $496 million in cash. How will you use that capital?
Significant amount of that capital will be used to build our robotic fleet. As you mentioned, we have a robot as a service business model. So that means the robotic systems stay on our balance sheet. So we fund those and maintain them. So a fair bit of the capital will go towards that. We'll also continue our R&D. We have been a tremendous engine of innovation over the years, and we will continue to do so. We'll start building up our artificial intelligence platform. And then finally, we have the opportunity to look at rolling up some acquisitions in the robotics space. You know, there aren't very many pure play robotics companies that the public can invest in. We think we're uniquely situated to find other bolt-on acquisitions that could further expand and enhance our mission and allow the public investors to participate alongside of us in that.
So who would be some of your end users here, potentially?
Our end users are from a whole wide variety of industries. If you look at warehousing and logistics, if you look at air transport, and then manufacturing. So automobile manufacturers, aircraft manufacturers, and then finally the military. So a wide range of industries, really any place that humans are being asked to do physically demanding work, we can provide a solution.
I understand you still haven't launched these products yet. That's just going underway. Have you had any orders yet? Any interest?
Yeah, so we've publicly talked about a number of very large Fortune 100 and Fortune 500 companies that we have partnered with, companies like Caterpillar and Delta Airlines, companies in the automobile sector, others in the aviation sector, construction industry. And we have around 7,000 units that we've been in discussion with those marquee lighthouse customers. We don't talk about it being backlogged because it's not contractually committed yet, but certainly just a handful of customers are already talking to us about some fairly significant orders.
Very exciting. What else is on the docket for the rest of the next few months or so?
Well, getting the merger completed obviously is one big thing. On the exoskeleton front, getting our beta units completed, and by the end of the year, having them out in the field trialing with customers. We have previously had our alpha units last year in the field. So now we're looking forward to taking all of the learnings from the alpha units, building them into the beta units, and getting those into our customers' hands by the end of this year.
I'm so excited to continue following this story. Ben, good to meet you. Thanks a lot.
Christine, thanks for your time. I appreciate it.